Hey guys, welcome back. So I think there's a lot of confusion out there regarding VPNs. Some people are saying that you must use a VPN. Other people are saying that a VPN is only necessary if you're torrenting. There's confusion about what happens to the speed and lots of other stuff. So I thought I'd make this quick video and basically go over some of the most common questions and give you my take on them. So with all of that being said, let's get started. So question one, what is a VPN? So a VPN stands for Virtual Private Network, and it's a method of connecting to the internet or to another network in a secure manner where your traffic is encrypted. So let's just put that into real life. So right now, if I want to access Netflix or to a website, my computer will make a connection through my ISP, and from my ISP, I'll make a connection to Netflix. And then I'm then able to stream that content. So if I want to watch a movie or stream a TV show, I can do that. Now, if Netflix were able to check their logs, they would see that this IP address belonging to Tech Doctor in the UK has made this connection and is currently streaming The Walking Dead, for example. Now, in the case of VPN, if I do install a VPN onto my computer or onto my Android box or onto my Fire Stick, the job of that software is to basically encrypt my traffic. So what that means is before my traffic actually leaves my computer or my Android box, the VPN software will encrypt that traffic and it'll create a secure tunnel to a VPN server that I choose. So let's say, for example, I decide to choose a VPN server in Canada. So the VPN software will encapsulate and encrypt my traffic and send it directly to a VPN server in Canada. Now, the job of the Canada VPN server is, or all VPN servers, is to basically decrypt that traffic and then forward you on to the target destination. So in my case, it would be Netflix. Now, if Netflix were now to check their logs, they'll see the IP address of the actual VPN server in Canada. So there'll be no trace of me actually accessing Netflix in their logs. So this would give you some form of anonymous networking because as the data left my computer, that was encrypted. So for example, my ISP can't see what's inside that traffic tunnel, but also from a Netflix point of view, they'll see that this connection was made from Canada, not from the UK. So for example, if there are shows or if there's certain movies or certain TV shows only available to Canadian users, then this way I can use a VPN and now access that content. Okay, so next up we have, will I lose speed with a VPN? And the short and easy answer is yes, 100%. As previously mentioned, when you're using a VPN server or VPN, you're not making a connection directly from your computer to the target destination. You're going via somewhere else first. So anytime you add an extra point or an extra hop in the journey, that is going to cause you some delay. So that is going to slow you down. Now the question is how much speed I'm going to lose and what I can do to limit the speed. Now, to determine how much speed you'll lose, there's a couple of different factors at play. So if I choose a VPN server which is geographically really far away from me, so I'm in the UK, so I purposely choose a VPN server based in Australia. Now, because of that physical distance, all of my data, all of my traffic has to go via UK all the way to Australia. Then depending on where the actual website is, then route from there onto the website or onto the service. So let's have, for example, I choose to browse amazon.co.uk. So presumably those servers will be hosted in the UK. But because I've chosen to go via a VPN server based in Australia, that is severely going to reduce my speed because that data flow will have to go UK, Australia, back to UK. So the general rule of thumb is whichever service or whichever target destination you're going to go to, try and choose a VPN server in that location, or alternatively, just choose a VPN server that's very close to you. So you basically minimize that latency from your device to the VPN server and then from there onto the target destination. That's probably the first thing you can do to mitigate the speed loss when using a VPN. Now, the second thing, which is also quite an interesting point, a lot of it does depend on which device you're using. So, me doing a VPN speed test on my computer, using the same VPN, IPVanish, connecting to the same VPN server, something based in London, we'll see the results of that speed test are greatly different to me doing the exact same speed test on my Meeple box, for example. Now, the reason for that is obviously when your device is encrypting data, it's encrypting packets, it's allowing these things to run in the background, that is going to cause overhead for your device. So, if your device is not very powerful, that is going to affect your speed. Now, also, when I ran the same speed test on a Fire Stick, that was by far the slowest. So, we can clearly see, depending on the power of your device, will greatly affect what kind of speeds you see when using a VPN server. So let's just see this test in action. So on the top left-hand side is my computer without any VPN running, and we can see I get around about 70 meg. On the top right, I've enabled IP Vanish, and we can see I get around about 60 meg or so, so I've lost about 10 meg. And on the bottom left, I'm using my Meeko box, and there we can see I've lost about 25 meg or so. So we can see the more power that the box has, or my computer in this case, it has a less impact on the speed. The slower your box is, or the slower your device is, that will have a greater impact on your overall speed with VPN. So to close off this point, I would say, yes, of course, you are going to lose some speed when using a VPN. But as we've seen now, a lot of it does depend on what kind of device you're using, which kind of VPN servers you're connecting to. But also, we must take into account that if privacy or, you know, staying anonymous online is your number one priority, then losing 10 or 20 or even 30 meg of speed, is that worth it or not? So that's something that you really have to decide for yourself. So I know for the majority of people though, as long as this doesn't really affect their browsing or when they're streaming stuff, having the VPN enabled, as long as their speed doesn't drop below like 20 meg or so, which is more than enough for doing HD streaming, then really it shouldn't be of concern. Next up, we have probably the most common question I've been asked regarding VPNs, which is, do I have to use a VPN? Now, I think to answer this one, I would say it really depends on who you are and what you do on your computer. So, I mean, what are the most common reasons for using a VPN? I would say probably security and privacy is probably the main reason, which basically means like, let's say, for example, you're at a coffee shop or you're using some public Wi-Fi. Do you really want to be doing your banking or shopping over an unsecured network? And the answer should be most definitely not. So if you're doing some kind of banking transactions or, you know, shopping, you definitely do not want to do that over an unsecured network. So for that, definitely, if you do have a VPN, that's definitely the time you do want to use it. The next reason we probably have is to get around geo restrictions. So this basically means like, if I'm in the UK and I travel to another country, but I still want to watch BBC iPlayer, because of geofencing, the BBC iPlayer servers will only allow connections from UK-based IP addresses. So one way around that would be to connect to a VPN server based in the UK, and I'm then able to access that content. Another big reason is to get around restrictions in your country. So I know, for example, in China, or certain parts of China, you're not able to access Twitter or Facebook. So if you do want to use a social media platforms, the only option you have is to use a VPN, because once again, if you go via VPN, they can't actually see what you're looking at, so you're able to access that content. Now, probably the two main reasons which you could classify as gray areas, depending on where you are, is streaming content and then also torrenting. Now, I think with torrenting, there's not really much of a debate. So, and the big reason with torrenting, because that's something else that people have asked me, is what's the big deal with torrenting? So I would say probably the biggest issue with torrenting is not really the fact that you're downloading this potentially copyrighted content. It's basically the fact that your client is also sending out that potentially copyrighted material. So the fact that you're sharing that stuff, that's what causes basically the red flags and the alarms when people are using torrents. So again, if you do use a VPN that does support torrents, then if you do want to download something, I mean, in certain countries or certain ISPs, they actually block torrent traffic. So you can actually find normal things on torrents, like for example, Linux distributions or other large files. Instead of having a single server serving you like a 2 gig or a 5 gig file, it's just a lot more efficient to do it through torrents. So even though that file, that distribution of Linux is totally legal and nobody will ever question you because it's open source, the fact that it comes via torrents, if your ISP is blocking torrents, then you're not going to be able to use it. So once again, if you were to use a VPN, you will be able to access that content. Now, if you're just a typical user who just uses like YouTube or Twitter or Facebook, doesn't really do any kind of like streaming or torrenting, it's not really concerned about if the ISP knows what they're looking at, then really I can't see any benefit of you having a VPN, because as we've seen with the previous question, wherever VPN you go for, you will lose some of your speed. So if the previous reasons I mentioned are not really applicable to you, then I really can't see any benefit of you then going for a VPN, because you're just not the use case for it. So last up, we've got some of the smaller questions. So first up, we've got, is it legal to use a VPN? Now, using a VPN is legal in most countries, except I think there's about 6 or so where you're not allowed to use it. Countries like Iran, China, I believe also in Russia now it's been banned, Turkey, North Korea, and there's a few more. So as long as you're not in one of those countries, you're able to use a VPN without any kind of legal issues whatsoever. Next up we have, can I use a free VPN? Yes, of course, you can use a free VPN. It's totally free to try out. But the question I always get asked is, how come this VPN is free? Generally, and by and large, when anything is free online, there's a reason why it's free, which means either they're selling your data, they're monitoring what you're doing, or lots of different reasons. So big services like, Facebook or Gmail or, these other big platforms, the reason why they're free is, as they say, when a product that you're using is free, then you yourself are the product that's being sold because they're monitoring what you're doing, they're selling your browsing habits, or they're selling your preferences, or they're giving you, specific adverts based on who you are, what kind of stuff you look at. So that's why it's free. So similarly with a free VPN, yes, you can use it, but I'll be very, very careful about what you do using a free VPN. Next up we have, what does a VPN kill switch do? So as the name implies, on certain VPNs, you can set up a kill switch, which basically means that if your VPN was to be terminated for whatever reason, either you can get it to turn off your internet connection, or you can also make it shut down a program. So let's say, for example, you're using a torrent client because you want to download something. You can set the application in your kill switch so that application can only run if the VPN is running. If the VPN stops for whatever reason, then the application will be terminated. And that way you can guarantee that you're not accessing any of these applications without your VPN running. Someone said VPN will give you more speed. I actually saw this on a Review Dog's channel. Great guy. Definitely check him out. If you're not subscribed, definitely subscribe to that guy. And the reason why he's saying that, certain ISPs are known to throttle certain protocols, which means as they're monitoring your traffic, they can see that, oh, Tech Doctor is now using peer-to-peer or torrents. So because he's using torrents, I'm going to limit how much bandwidth he can have. And they are perfectly able to do that. So one way around that would be to use a VPN. So if I wasn't using it, and because my ISP is throttling my connection, let's say I'm only getting 20 meg of my normal speed, as soon as I use a VPN, because they can't see that traffic, I should be able to get more speed. So that's why that statement that using a VPN in certain conditions, or specifically when your ISP is throttling you, it can help you speed up your connection. And lastly, we have, how can I find a good VPN to use? So I personally use IPVanish. I've also used NordVPN in the past. The good thing with most of these VPN providers is you do have 30-day no quibble money back guarantee. So you can try it out, give it a go, and see how it affects your speed. See if it does give you the privacy or the anonymous network connectivity. If that does meet your requirements, then you can carry on. If for whatever reason you don't like it, you have the option to get all of your money back. Well, that's all for this video, guys. Many thanks for watching, and many thanks for staying till the end. If you did enjoy the video, then do press that thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, then definitely do subscribe and hit that notification bell. And I'll hopefully see you guys on the next one. Thanks. Thanks again for watching, guys. Oh, and if you're interested in a VPN, if you click on that link on the bottom left, you'll get a great 46% discount. If you are worried about your privacy and you want to stay safe online, I do recommend you check out a VPN. Thanks again, guys. See you on the next one.